Hello friends, today we will see DDA line drawing algorithm and how the algorithm has been set up, and later we will also see a C graphics program for generating line using DDA line algorithm on the output screen. This algorithm is a very old algorithm. Okay, in the 1960s, okay, the algorithm was developed, and it was developed for monochromatic displays. Okay, so the displays were of the kind, as you can see on the screen, they had very low resolution and the presence of pixel was mentioned by highlighting the respective pixel position, and absence of pixel means the pixel is not highlighted. So presence of pixel and absence of pixel, these were the two events or two properties of the display device, and it didn't had any color or other properties during that time, and the memories were also very low in the working memories, that is random access memory used to be in some bytes, and that is the reason why the algorithm should be optimized in such a way that if you want to display a geometric shape on such a low resolution display device, then your algorithm should be very efficient and it should display the geometrical shapes fairly quickly. So that was the main requirement. And as you can see, this is a 6x6 display, monochromatic display, and it is very convenient to display horizontal lines and vertical lines because I can highlight the subsequent pixels, okay, which are comprising of a straight line, either horizontal or vertical. And it is also fairly convenient to display a 45 degree line, and as far as the displays are concerned, okay, generally the top left corner, okay, top left corner of a display device is considered as origin. So this is a positive x axis, and vertically downward direction, that is positive y axis. So I have this positive x axis and this is positive y axis, and this is the origin. Okay, this is the origin of display device. So keeping that thing in mind, we try to write the programs keeping top left corner of my display device as the origin, and it, as you can see over here, it is very convenient to display vertical line, horizontal line or 45 degree line. But if my line has some other slope, so horizontal line will have slope 0, vertical line will have slope infinity, 45 degree line will have slope 1. So if I have slope value for my line any other than these three values, then it's a challenge for me to display that shape, okay, display that line effectively on a low resolution display device. Say for example, if I have to display this 1, 1, 5, 3 line, okay, this is 1, 1, 5, 3 line, okay, these question mark positions are the positions through which the line, the hypothetical line which we are drawing, is passing. This line, how I have drawn? I have drawn this line by marking the center of my first pixel position, that is 1, 1, and center of the last pixel position, that is 5, 3, which I want. And now I have joined this line. This is a hypothetical line. Okay, now this line actually passes through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pixel positions. But it is not convenient to highlight all 7 because the shape that it will generate will not look like a line. So while trying to display geometric shapes on a display device, the first requirement is the geometric shape should look like the geometric shape which you want to display. So line should look like line, circle should look like circle. Okay, so that is the first requirement. The second most important requirement is the geometric shape should get displayed rapidly. So let's say you are running the program and the geometric shape getting displayed after some time. Okay, so that is not what we want. So the shape that we want to display should get displayed rapidly. So rapidness program should have, then accuracy program should have, and it should look like the shape that it is representing. So these 3-4 basic requirements will always be there for any geometric algorithm, okay, which we want to display, any geometric shape which we want to display on a display device. So I can display these two pixels, or I can even display these two pixels. So now there is a fair amount of confusion, which is the pixel position that I will display so that my shape will look like a line shape. For that reason, we are going to write, or we are going to learn, the digital differential analyzer algorithm. Okay, now what the digital differential analyzer does is, okay, for drawing any line, we want starting point of the line and ending point of the line. And when I say starting point and ending point of the line, I mean I want the starting point coordinates and ending point coordinates. So the coordinates will be in the form of x comma y. So if it is a first point, it is going to be x1 comma y1, and for the last point it is going to be x2 comma y2. Okay, so these two points, if I have, I should be able to generate line. And the same thing applies to the computer program as well. So if I have these two endpoints, I will write an algorithm, then I will convert it into a program, and I will display line onto the display device. So digital differential analyzer is a scan conversion line algorithm by calculating either delta y or delta x. Now what is delta y? Delta y is a difference between y coordinates. So it is y2 minus y1, and delta x is x2 minus x1. So we find the difference and we try to find out which is larger, and once we know which value is larger, then we can do further calculations. So consider a first line with a positive slope. So let's say this line has a positive slope, okay, and this slope is less than or equal to 1. So the line that we are going to draw is in a region between 0 degree to 45 degree, okay, 0 degree to 45 degree, and all the lines between this region will have slope less than or equal to 1. So we sample at unit x intervals, so that is delta x equal to 1. So here you will find that delta x in this region will always be 1, and we compute each successive y value as y of k plus 1 equal to yk plus m. So y of k plus 1 means k takes the integer value starting from 1, that is a counter variable, for the first point and increases by 1 until the final endpoint is reached. Since m, okay, here m is the slope of the line, m can be any real number between 0 to 1, the calculated y value must be rounded to the nearest integer. So I don't have to actually round x, because x will always be 1. So xk plus 1 is going to be xk plus 1, okay, in this line that is slope less than or equal to 1. I will always calculate the y coordinate, the next y coordinate, and that I will calculate as yk plus 1, that is next position of y is equal to current position of y plus slope. Okay, so since the slope maximum can be 1 and at all other times it will be less than 1, so the slope value will be a fraction value or a decimal point value. So I will always have to round it off, because my pixel positions are all integers. Okay, I cannot have a 1.5 and 2.3 pixel location, because that is not possible. These are numbers, so these are always whole numbers, and that is the reason why I will have to round these numbers up, okay, to the nearest integer. Okay, for lines with a positive slope greater than 1, okay, so now the region between 45 degree and 90 degree, okay, these calculations gets reversed. So we reverse the roles of x and y, that is we sample at unit y intervals. So for that, delta y is always 1, and calculate each succeeding x value as, so this is the next section line, that is between 45 degree and 90 degree, and we calculate the x value as xk plus 1 equal to xk plus 1 by m. Okay, xk plus 1 by m. Okay, similarly, we have the remaining two conditions, that is, so far these two equations, okay, are based on the assumption that lines are to be processed from left endpoint to the right endpoint. So closer to the origin to the away from the origin. So we always have assumed that x1, y1 is here, x2, y2 is here. But that is not necessary. Okay. I can say my x1, y1 is here, x2, y2 is here. So will this algorithm work in a similar way? It won't. Okay. So for that reason, if I have my starting point of the line away from the origin and end point of the line closer to the origin, okay, and I am in the first section, that is between 0 degree to 45 degree, then I will take delta x as minus 1, and if I am in the second section, then I will take delta y as minus 1. That is the only change that I will make. Rest all the algorithm remains as it is. Okay, so these are the geometrical aspects of the digital differential analyzer, and now we will try to write a algorithm, okay, which will give us stepwise calculation that is needed, okay, and with that kind of calculation we will be able to print the required pixels, okay, onto the display device and represent the required line effectively. Okay, and as you can see, for these two cases, so the first case, okay, this slope, okay, so slope less than or equal to 1, and I'm starting from away from the origin coming towards the origin, so yk plus 1 is yk minus m. Okay, and in this case, if I'm starting from away from origin and coming towards origin, the xk plus 1 value is given as xk minus 1 by m. So that is the only difference, plus and minus. Okay, that is the only difference. And now we will see DDA algorithm. So read the start and end points of line and store them in x1, y1 and x2, y2 respectively. Then the second step, we will find the difference, that is x2 minus x1 is dx and y2 minus y1 is dy. Then I will have if statement. So if absolute of dx is greater than absolute of dy, then step equal to dx, else step equal to dy. So step is a limit variable, okay, step is a limit variable, and absolute means in mathematical terms it is modulus of that number. So dx is a difference between x2 and x1, so if that difference is negative, okay, so while I'm checking, I will only consider the magnitude. So similarly, the modulus function in mathematics works in a similar way. So that is absolute function in C language. Then I will find out the increment values respectively for x and y. So x increment is given as absolute of dx divided by step, and y increment is given as absolute of dy divided by steps. Now if dx is greater, okay, if dx is greater, then I am in the first region, that is 0 degree to 45 degree, and I will have step equal to dx, and that is the reason why x increment will become dx divided by dx eventually, and that is going to be 1, and y increment will be always less than 1. Okay, y increment will always less than 1, and that is the reason why we will be using round function to bring the y increment value to the, or rather y coordinate value to the closest integer. Okay, after this calculation we will plot the first point, that is x1 comma y1. So for plotting we use a put pixel command, okay, put pixel command in C graphics. Then our for loop begins. Okay, so for k equal to 0, k is my counter variable, k less than step. Okay, so I am limiting my k value till it is less than step. What I have to calculate? X equal to x plus x increment. Okay, then y equal to y plus y increment. What I will do next, I will just plot the x and y, but I will first round them up. Okay, so I will plot round x comma round y, then I will increment k, and that is going to be the end of loop. So this loop will continue from k equal to 0 till it is less than steps. So the moment k becomes equal to steps, the for loop will end and we will come out of the loop, and that is going to be the end of program. Okay, so I hope this DD algorithm has been understood well. Okay, now we will see a C program of this DDA algorithm. Okay, and I will just showcase the function, okay, the DDA function that is written. So this is a function DDA, that is hash include device dot h, okay, void line DDA. So it is accepting four arguments: integer xa, integer ya, integer xb, integer yb. So int dx equal to xb minus xa, dy equal to yb minus ya, steps and k. Okay, so all these are the declarations we are doing. Then float x increment, y increment, x equal to xa, y equal to ya. Now if absolute of dx greater than absolute of dy, steps equal to absolute of dx, else step equal to absolute of dy. So here we are confirming what is the slope. So if dx is greater, that means we are in the first region. If dy is greater, that means we are in the second region. Okay, now x increment is calculated as dx divided by float of steps, y increment is calculated as dy divided by float of steps, and immediately we are printing the first pixel. So set pixel can also be used, or put pixel can also be used. We will see shortly in a C program how these things are written. Then I have a for loop for k equal to 0, k less than steps, k plus plus, x plus equal to x increment, y plus equal to y increment, and then I am again printing the rounded x and y values. Okay, so in short, this is the very simple line generation program and very basic line generation program. Okay, nowadays we use a very advanced version of similar algorithms. Okay, now we will see a C program of DDA line generation algorithm. So now we will see DDA line drawing algorithm. So this is a Turbo C++ package for Windows 10. Okay, it is very light package, somewhere around 7.5 MB, and it is easily downloadable from internet. So I have included few header files: hash include stdio.h, that is standard input output, then hash include math.h, then hash include conio.h, and I have included hash include graphics.h. So this is a new part, that is graphics.h. So we will be using the graphics drivers to start the graphic screen, okay, onto the output screen, and then we will be displaying the geometric shapes. I have a global function, that is hash define round, and I am passing a argument, that is val. What I am doing, I am calculating the integer part of val plus 0.5. Okay, I have a void main function. I have graphics variable declaration, that is int gd equal to detect comma gm, that is the graphical driver and graphical mode variable. So the data type is integer for these. Then I have a function declaration, that is void line underscore dda, and it is going to accept four integer arguments. Then I am in declaring four integer variables for the starting and ending point of line, that is xa, xb, ya, yb, and then I am writing a printf, that is output statement, enter the two coordinates of endpoints of line, and then I have an input statement scanf and four times percent %d for the integer data type, and using the ampersand operator I am storing those values respectively in xa, ya, xb, yb. So it is expected from user that he enters the coordinates. So coordinates are always entered in x, y form. Then I will initialize the graphics driver function. So this is initialize graphics driver. So in short, it is called as init graph. Okay, it's a defined function in C and the syntax remains same. Okay, you cannot change the syntax. So it is accepting two basically graphics variables as arguments, so ampersand gd comma ampersand gm, and the third is a physical address where the turbo C++ package graphic drivers are stored. So the location is c:\turboc3/bgi. So bgi is a folder where graphics drivers are stored. So that physical address we need to pass in the double quotes, close the bracket and semicolon. So this is a initialized graphics driver function from C graphics. So the definition is stored in this graphics.h header file. Then I am clearing the device. So clear device is again a graphical function which works in a similar way as clear screen, okay, in normal C output. Then I am calling a function. So I am making a function call line_dda xAyA xByB. Four arguments I am passing. So the moment I make a function call, the compiler will transfer its scope into the function. So here I have defined the function. So void line DDA int xA int yA int xB int yB. Then I am calculating, declaring and calculating at the same time. So dx is xb minus xa, dy is yb minus ya. Then I have a limit variable steps and a counter variable k. I am inputting the four float variables as well. So x in is for x increment, y in is for y increment, x equal to xa, y equal to ya. Okay. If absolute of dx is greater than absolute of dy, okay, we have seen this step, it is written as it is, so steps equal to absolute of dx, else steps equal to absolute of dy. I am writing x in as dx divided by float of steps. Now as you can see over here, I have used typecasting. See, dx we have entered as integer and steps also we have entered as integer, but x in is entered as float. Okay, so if we only write dx divided by steps, okay, it is going to be integer divided by integer and it will be integer at the end, and a float cannot be assigned to an integer value. So that is why we are typecasting it and changing momentarily the steps to float, and then integer divided by float will be float and the float value will be assigned to x integer. Same thing happening with y integer as well. And then we are printing the pixel position. So this is the printing the pixel on output screen. Okay, so put pixel is a print command which prints the required xy location with a color code. So it accepts it is basically a defined function. Again, it's not a command, it's a function. So put pixel is a function which accepts three arguments. First two arguments will be the xy coordinates and the last argument is going to be the color code. So round x, round y, this round is a global function which we have written over here with the help of hash define. Then we enter into the for loop. For k equal to 0, k less than steps, k plus plus, x equal to x plus x increment, y equal to y plus y increment, put pixel, round of x, round of y, again the color code. We have given delay of 100 just to showcase in what manner the line is getting printed, and end of the for loop and end of the function. Okay, the scope again comes back to the function call and it transfers to the next line, that is getch, to connect the input output screens. Then I close the graphical function that we have started, that is init graph. So close graph will release the memory which it allocated to run the graphic function. And then I have the end of the program. So this is my end of program. Okay, I hope you have understood. Let us try to run this. Okay, so okay, I have just compiled the program. There are no errors. Okay, I will try to run the program. So I am going to input the coordinates. Now I will take an example of a coordinate, let's say 100 comma 100 and 500 comma 300. I will press enter and slowly, as you can see, with the help of that delay of 100 milliseconds, okay, the line is getting displayed slowly. Each and every pixel position is getting highlighted with a delay of 100 milliseconds and it is going in the going from start point to the end point of the line. Okay, this is a very convenient and very simple algorithm, and the program also contains very less number of lines. Okay, there are few drawbacks of this algorithm. The algorithm requires that I have to divide the two values. So I find the x increment using the division of two values, two variables. So division compared with other mathematical operations takes more time, and there is possibility that I may get into a divide by zero error. Okay, so at those points or at those conditions, the program may malfunction or the program may not work. So as far as possible, trying to display geometrical shapes on a graphical screen, we try to avoid division operation coming into the algorithm. So this is one drawback, and since the division operation takes time, okay, the algorithm is not fast. Algorithm is not fast, and also it is not accurate, because it only tries to identify the next pixel position based on a mathematical calculation. It doesn't check any other condition. So there are two, three drawbacks of this algorithm, and to overcome these drawbacks, okay, there were some other algorithms written, which we will see in the coming lecture series. So I hope you have understood the C program as well as DDA line algorithm, and understood how the line can be displayed on a display device using a graphical driver, okay, and including the graphics.h header file in a C program. So I hope this was understood well. I'll see you in the next lecture of the CAD CAM CAE lecture series. Thank you all.